Hi everyone, I'm Ryan La Sala, the author of Reverie, a young adult fantasy novel out with Source Books on December 3rd, so in just about a month. So many of you probably know me from Twitter or maybe from that video that I did when I was going to Children's Institute where I got into costume as a literal child in the hopes of blending in. Don't worry, Source Books confiscated my makeup kit, my arts and crafts, so this is going to be a very straightforward video. The subject of this video is a thank you. It's a thank you to you, to independent booksellers. Thank you for saying hello to me at events. Thank you for talking with me. Thank you for supporting Reverie. Thank you for supporting books that are like Reverie. And I just got this news recently. Thank you so much for making Reverie a indie next pick for winter 2019-2020. I have chills right now. I can't even like describe to you the sound that I made when I got this news. It was absolutely inhuman. Anyhow, I thought it might be handy to put together like a quick pitch for readers, because Reverie is admittedly a kind of hard book to describe. So Reverie is a book about Kay Montgomery, who is a young queer kid growing up in Connecticut, who has to battle against a drag queen sorceress for the creative rights to reality. And those battles take place in these vast living dreamt worlds called Reveries, and they can be any plot, they can have any genre, and they absolutely react to the actions that people take in them. So it's a super bizarre, like, fantastical story that spans a bunch of different worlds, and it's for those readers that have always daydreamed about entering their favorite books or their favorite bookshelves. So Kane is one of those readers, and as he finds out, some daydreams are not so quick to let you go. I actually wrote Reverie as a direct response to a lot of the books that I was reading as a teenager. I started the book when I was in high school, when I was the same age as the characters, as sort of this like fan fiction of not really my own life, but of the characters that I wished were out there in books. I really wanted to read about queer heroes, and I wanted to read about a group of queer friends, and eventually I wanted to write a story that showed queer kids that there's literally no such genre, no such plot that they cannot exist in, and further, that they cannot be the hero of. So it's for those readers, but it's also for anybody that just loves a, you know, a fun fantasy adventure. It's for people that understand the importance of dreams, but also the danger of getting too caught up in your own head. So there is a lot in here, and quite frankly, books like this would have a hard time if not for independent booksellers and bookstores. You and your stores create spaces for every kind of reader, and it means a ton to readers like me, but also books like Reverie, and I'm absolutely honored to have your support. I'm really looking forward to the next year. I hope I get to meet a ton of you, and if you see me, say hi. And if you see Source Books, please tell them to give me back my makeup.